Do it even more so if you're flirting with a certain mister. And if you've a form, wear clothes to emphasize it. And if you are warm, oh, it pays to advertise it. So put a little rhythm in every little thing you put a little rhythm in everything you do.
Where is she?
She grabbed her hat and coat and beat it.
All right. What's her name?
Flag. Curly Flag.
Find her. Now you.
Yes, sir.
All aboard. Trenton, Princeton, New York. All aboard.
How much to New York?
$1.50, miss.
Well, how far will 75 cents take me?
Princeton.
Okay, Princeton.
Come in.
Hey, wait a minute. I mean, come in. What can I do for you?
Well, I was watching you through that window, and when I saw you eating the cake, I couldn't help it.
Oh, is that what you want, a piece of cake? Well, here, that's a cinch. You want a glass of water? Sorry we haven't got anything stronger, but there's gin ordered. It ought to be here by now. You feel better?
Yeah. I was awful hungry.
What, you broke? Mm-hmm. You don't mean you're actually starving?
Well, I don't suppose you really starve for about a week or 10 days.
Oh, well, here. We'll go down to a restaurant and get you fed right.
I can't.
Why not?
The police are after me.
The police?
Yeah.
Well, what is it?
It's a murder case.
Murder?
Oh, but I didn't do it. They want me for a material witness.
You mean you actually saw somebody get murdered?
Yeah, but I didn't know the guy that done it. I only saw the back of his head. You see, I was doing my number at the time.
Number?
Yeah, at the hilarity club where I work. I didn't even take time to change. Look. I knew a girl once that got mixed up in a murder. Perfectly innocent, you understand. And they held her in jail for 4 months. I ain't gonna sit in no jail for 4 months.
Gee, can they really do that to you?
Sure, if you can't put up no bond.
That's a darn shame. Say, look, my allowance doesn't come until next week, but I can let you have...
That's no use. This is big-time murder. They'll be watching for me everywhere. It's no good taking your money and walking right out in a cop's arms.
Well, there must be something we can do about it.
Say, you boys got a pretty good break.
You know, it's nice here. Can I have a cigarette?
Oh, sure.
Thanks. I looked in your window a long time before I got my nerve up. You looked like somebody that might help a girl. Did you say you was expecting some gin?
Well, I guess.
Say, that sounds like somebody doing taps.
Huh?
Listen.
Oh, that's Buzz Jones. He has the room over this. He's a swell tap dancer.
Yeah.
Say, I think I'll go up and talk to Buzz for a minute. You stay here.
You'll be back.
Oh, yes. We'll figure some way to help you out of this.
The condition of the banking structure depends upon the government credit. The condition of the banking structure depends upon government credit. I said the condition of the banking structure depends upon the government credit.
Hey, Buzz. What do you think I got downstairs in my room?
I'm on the wagon until after commencement.
No, it's a girl, a chorus girl, right out of a nightclub and still all dolled up in the black panties and the brassiere.
Lift up my typewriter and you'll find Mae West.
Now listen, this is on the level.
You mean you got a girl in your room? A female girl?
That's what I've been trying to tell you. A nightclub chorus girl.
And only 2 weeks before you graduate. Listen, Paul, it's not worth it. You better chase her out of Princeton so fast.
I can't. She's wanted by the police. She's mixed up in a murder.
Will you get out of here and let me continue with my studying?
No, Buzz, honest, it's true. She's down there. She didn't do the murder, she just saw it done. And the police want her for a witness. Say they can put her in jail for 6 months or a year until the case comes to trial, if it ever does. She's in trouble and we got to help her.
You get into the darndest messes. How do you do it?
Well, you're in this one too now. I declared you in.
Just a pal. You know how it's going to look if we're caught.
Yes, but... Well, if one man were caught hiding a girl in a dormitory, it might look bad. Very bad. But two men? No. At Yale, yes, but not at Princeton.
Mr. Lawton.
My, you give me a turn.
Me too. I thought you was a burglar.
You all alone here?
What's it to you?
It's nothing to me, little girl, only I'll give you a tip, see? This is no place for a girl in a student's room. The college has got laws for that. If they was to catch you here, they'd make you wish you'd never seen this man's town. I'm telling you straight, see? If I was you...
Suppose you try it on your piano.
All right. Go on your own sweet little way, little girl. All right. Only if I was you.
Well, you're not. And that's a break for me.
You know best. You think.
Say, it's a good thing the other fellows in this entry are out tonight.
Yeah, we're taking plenty of risks as it is.
Well, we can't let the police here.
I got into a muss with them once myself.
Oh, this is Buzz Jones.
Pleased to meet you. My name's Curly Flagg.
Miss Flagg, we're going to take care of you. Now, let me see. I have it. We'll dress her up in boys' clothes. I'll sneak into the fourth entry and swipe some of Shorty's.
Swipe some of whose?
Quiet, please. She can't hide around here in her own clothes. As a matter of fact, you said she wasn't wearing any.
I've got on my dancing clothes.
Well, obviously, you can't hang around Princeton in that. It wouldn't be fair to you or to Princeton. But what we can do is dress her up like a boy. Keep people from getting close to her. At a distance, she'll pass. She's your kid cousin. Just come down to visit you and see Princeton. Hopes to enter it someday.
I don't know. I've seen a lot of girls on the stage in boys' clothes, and they look sort of different.
Well, I realize that. We'll dress her in baggy things.
Trousers, for instance.
Slacks. Of course, we'll have to cut her hair.
What?
Did you ever cut anybody's hair?
No, I can't say that I have.
Don, that's tough. I never have either. Well, we'll just have to do our best. How about scissors?
I only got nail scissors.
They'll just have to do.
Okay.
Wait a minute. I can't say I'm crazy.
Quiet, please. I'm thinking.
Well, so am I. And if you think I'm going to turn you boys loose on my hair with nail scissors, you've...
My dear young woman, I must ask you not to interrupt. Would you rather we trim your hair or turn you over to the police? Now, we're willing to help you. We're taking great risks ourselves, but unless you cooperate...
Well... Do you think I ought to?
Sure.
Okay.
Get the scissors.
Right.
It'll grow out again in jail, I suppose.
You're not going to jail. Next.
Here we are.
You cut her hair, Paul. I'll go dig up those clothes.
Here, here. Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Huh?
I'll have to study this.
Well, don't make me look like that.
Get the clothes. Hold your breath. Hold still.
Wait a minute, listen.
No time for listening now.
Yeah, but this is something you ought to know. A man came in while you were upstairs.
Huh?
Yeah, through the window, sort of a tramp. He had a package with him. He stuck it under the desk and he left you that note.
Oh, that's Baldy Schultz. He left a bit of gin. He's the bootlegger.
Yeah. Well, for a bootlegger, he shocks awful easy. Hell, I thought they'd all been given licenses now to run drugstores.
Well, he's an old-fashioned bootlegger. You see, this university is supposed to be dry. Well, do you want me to stop where I am?
No, you better even it up now if you can.
Well, I can't even it up if you're going to be racked with sobs. Now, hold still.
All right. Did you say that was gin?
Yeah, would a drink pacify you?
Well, it would certainly make me feel better. I need it.
Okay. Now, this is some of Baldy's very extra special. Contains no grit, no grime, no grease. There you are. Help yourself. I'll see what can be done on this side. Here, how's that one? Now, that was your fault.
What did you do?
Well, I just went a little deeper than I'd planned.
Oh.
All right.
Oh. Ah, performing the operation under an anesthetic, eh?
Yes.
How's it coming?
Not bad.
Hey! Oh.
Sorry? How does it look?
Well, it looks kind of chewed, but it could be worse.
Well, let me see. Say... Where's that mirror?
Right over there.
Oh, yeah. Oh!
I don't know about her feet, though. My shoes would be kind of roomy, and Shorty seems to be wearing his.
Hmm.
This magoo makes it look a whole lot better, doesn't it? There now. How's that? Boom. See, I make a pretty good-looking boy at that, don't I?
You look terrible.
Oh.
Well, here. You wait till you put these on.
I don't really hold the haircut against you. It was his idea. You've been awful sweet to me.
Isn't that touching?
Mm. Well, here. There are your clothes.
Thanks.
All right. You go right ahead.
You know, if they catch her, you and I are going to graduate awful sudden.
Yeah, I know. That's what makes it so tough. As if we had designs on her. Say, I wouldn't touch her if you gave her to me.
Me either.
Well, that's a nice thing to say.
As far as we're concerned, you're as safe here as you'd be in a monastery. I mean, a convent. How you doing?
Okay.
Where is she going to sleep?
I think I'll run up to New York tonight and tackle the old man about a job for her, so she can stay up in my room.
Yeah. And I'll write some friends about some work for her. I might even wire my uncle in Detroit.
Fine. Come on, Curly. I'll give you some pajamas and lock you in.
Yeah. Well, so long.
Good night. Now, if you need anything, just tap on the floor. I'll hear you.
Okay. Oh, I forgot.
Shh.
May need this. Well, see you later, my old college chum.
Here you are, kid. This is home for the next day or two.
Gee, this is a swell hideout.
I've got to throw some things together. Gosh, I won't get home till about 4 o'clock.
Do you live in New York?
Yeah. I'm going to strike my father about a job for you in the morning. Here you are.
Thanks. Look at, can you imagine me in these? Wow.
Which part are you going to wear?
Can I go in here?
Sure. Curly.
Yeah?
You can keep this door locked, you know.
Sure, don't worry.
You understand, if you get frightened or anything, or if someone tries the door or knocks, you just rap on the floor and that'll bring Paul up. He said he'd listen for you.
Thanks. He's a nice kid, that Paul. Oh, I found some sneaks.
There's a radio here. You can turn it on, but keep it low. Let me see. Shirt, socks. I think I'll take along a couple of books. I might get in a little work.
Look it, can you imagine?
Hey, not so loud. They can hear you to Trenton.
Say, this might be a funny costume for a number.
All right, all right. Practice your dancing. I've got to hurry if I'm going to get you a job. Curly, how would you like to go into the movies?
The movies?
Yeah, moving pictures.
You mean you know somebody?
I meant to tell you, my father's president of Supersound.
Oh, boy. Do you think he'd give me a job?
If I can persuade him.
Well, give him a good hot sales talk.
Sure. Well, so long. Be a good girl. Be a good boy.
Well, let me know.
You'll hear from our Mr. Jones. Good luck to you.
Hurry back.
Shh.
What's the matter? For heaven's sake, what's the matter?
Oh, why didn't you let me finish it? I was doing a dance for you.
A dance?
Yeah, I just routined a swell comedy dance. I want to show it to you.
Well, this is no time to be showing me a dance. Now, why don't you go to bed? You must be dead.
I'm feeling great. You boys have been so good to me, especially you. Gee, you're a swell kid.
Thanks, but I've got a 9 o'clock lecture. I've got to get some sleep.
Oh, don't walk out on me. Let's have a cigarette together.
No, I can't.
Sure you can. Sit down there.
Well?
Just a minute. We'll have a cigarette together. Or would you rather have a drink?
Oh, no. Just a cigarette. I'll have a couple of puffs and then to bed.
You don't have to go downstairs yet a while. Look, I get scared up here all alone. I get awful scared.
Well, sort of scares me, too.
Mm-hmm. You poor darling.
It's serious. You know, we're trying to help you, but we're taking awful chances to do it.
I know.
You got to be careful. You got to help us all you can.
Sure I will. There's nothing I wouldn't do for you.
Well, I hope Buzz gets to New York all right.
Oh, say, he's going to get me in pictures.
Oh, that's fine. The sooner the better.
Look, let me show you some of this dance. Just a couple of steps, and then you can go if you want to.
All right.
Now, wait till I get some music. Only, I've got to have a number to set it with the audience. Something like, my heart just beats and hammers when I'm in my sweetie's pajamas.
Well, hurry it up.
This is swell.
Now you listen to me, Curly Flag, and get this through your head. I got no more that kind of interest in you than I have in the United States Senate. No more than I'd have in a horse if I saw a man beating him and made him stop. That wouldn't mean I wanted to have a smoozling party with the horse, would it?
Oh,
Now, don't you ever do anything like that to me again.
You get out of here. You go on. And don't ever come back.
Good night.
You lousy barber!
Sure this is the girl?
It was her, all right. In the student's room where I was making a delivery. I even talked to her. She was fresh, too.
Here's Mr. Simpson.
Hiya, J.P.
Mug, this is our Princeton salesman. Handles booze on the side. He's located the girl down there.
Yeah?
Uh-huh. I've had a lot of trouble with you in this matter, Mug. Why do you have to pick out a nightclub to do your shooting in?
I like nightclubs.
Oh, you do, huh? Well, it means we got to get to the girl before the police find her. Now, you're going down there with Mr. Schultz, and you're going to take her for a little ride.
Fine, J.B. You know, I always feel better when I'm working. Come on.
Oh, you don't mind rubbing out a dame, do you, Mug?
It'll be a pleasure.
Well, haven't you any ideas?
Who, me?
Well, a publicity man is supposed to have ideas.
That's just a quaint old superstition.
But this is the worst picture we've ever made. Now something's got to be done.
Put it on the shelf.
And write off a quarter of a million? That's a brilliant idea.
Hello, Dad.
So get out of here. Can't you see that I'm busy?
But, Dad, all I want to do is talk to you.
Well, wait outside until I send for you.
I'll only take a minute. This is very important.
Yes, I know how important it is. Your mother told me at breakfast. And if you think all I have to do is to get you out of scrapes...
I'm not in any scrape.
And hereafter, when you come in at 4 o'clock in the morning, don't wake your mother up.
I didn't wake her up. She heard me coming in.
Now, wait outside. I'll attend to you later, young man. I haven't got worry enough, but he has to get mixed up with a nightclub dancer.
Buzz?
Yes. He and another student are keeping a girl in their rooms at Princeton. Got her dressed up as a boy. Told his mother all about it.
Told his mother?
Oh, it's perfectly innocent, of course. They're saving her from something worse than death.
From something or for something?
Yeah, she'd wanted by the police. That's their story.
What did the police want her for?
Murder.
Huh?
She committed a murder or she saw a murder committed over in Philadelphia. The idea is I'm to give her a job. I'm to hide her from the police by putting her on the screen.
Miss Flag Girl?
Yeah.
Say, there's an idea floating around here somewhere that might salvage our picture. Listen. Here's the way the story starts. There's a nightclub kid, a young girl, see, and pure. A beginner in a nightclub. Her folks don't know she's working in this place. Sweet old mother and a hard, tight-fisted, sanctimonious old father. Great characters. Well, one night when she's doing her number, there's a gang killing, see? All right. She runs away before they can pinch her. She doesn't know where to go. She wanders around aimlessly in the rain. Now you cut to a university town. A big university, rich and peaceful, crawling with money, rich men's sons. The girl walks into the picture. She's still wandering around among the buildings. There she is, starving, wanted by the police. She faints in the snow.
What?
It's turned cold. The young student finds her. He brings her in. He hears her story. He is moved. He can't send her away, and yet it isn't safe to keep her there in his room. Maybe his father is a rich New York politician. Great character.
Get me the coast.
You ain't heard the half of it. Here's what I'm doing. I'm tipping off the press that this kid is down in Princeton, but I'm going to beat him down there with a cameraman. If this girl is any good, I'll sign her up for Supersound and keep her on page one for a month with photographs while you toss L'Amour out on her ear and we'll put this kid in Love for Beginners. I'll make her the best-known woman that ever didn't commit a triple axe murder.
Send my son in.
Wait a minute. You better keep Buzz here in town tonight. If the newspaper boys get on to the fact that your son is mixed up in this, they'll smell a publicity stunt and drop it cold.
Oh, hello, Buzz, my boy. Come right in.
How are you, kid?
Say, you were sleeping so soundly this morning, I didn't have the heart to disturb you. I'm glad to see you, son.
Congratulations, boy. I hear you're quite a hero.
I'm proud of you, boy. Proud of you. That poor girl, cold and starving, wandering around in the rain.
Does Gus know about it?
Well, don't worry about Gus.
Tell me, is she pretty? Can she act?
She is an actress. She works in a nightclub.
Oh, we can use her, don't you think so, Gus?
And how?
Oh, thanks, Dad. I'll shoot right back to Princeton, and tonight after dark, I...
No, not today, son.
I should say not. Your dad needs you.
But I gotta get back.
Buzz, you don't want to see Supersound go into bankruptcy, do you? Listen, Buzz, the one picture that was going to save our lives has just arrived from the coast, and it's terrible. It smells. Everything in the world is wrong with it, but we don't know what. You're the only one that can tell us.
Me?
Yeah, you see, it's a college story, and none of my writers has ever been to college.
Now, you've got to see that picture on 2 or 3 times today. And tonight.
And tonight, you've got to tell us just what's wrong with it.
We were pretty worried till we thought about getting you to help us.
Miss Barco, have Love for Beginners run for my son, please. And I want it run through 5 or 6 times.
Hey,
it's great of you to do this for me.
I'm tipping off the United Press. That'll give us a spread. Hello, UP? Yeah. Mr. Rocco, please. Right.
Sam, listen. I ran off Love for Beginners last night, and it's terrible. It's putrid. Hey, what's the matter with you people out there? We gotta make it over. I got a new storyline I'm gonna give you, and I want you to get Bernie and Schwartz or any other writer who isn't busy to work on it. Now get Bernie on the phone for me.
Hello, Arco. Listen, Joe, this is Gus McNeil. Listen, Joe, I got the best gal darn story since the armistice. This yarn is... No, no, Joe. That's the funny part of it. Hasn't anything to do with the pictures at all. I just picked it up by accident. A little kid, friend of mine, I used to know on a show a couple of years ago.
Bernie, are you
I'll
ready?
Give you a load of
well, here's
exclusive.
Our start.
It doesn't make every
club.
Front page
a young
in the country.
Girl.
I'll
I'm
introduce
pure.
You to my
I'll
best
in
girl.
The nightclub.
You know the Hilarity murder in Philly?
Well, one night,
remember
in the middle of a number, there's a gang shooting takes
kid
place.
Paul Curley?
The kid gets frightened.
About
she
her.
Runs away.
She got
she
scared when
up
the police were looking for her, and she did a fade out. She took a bus for Princeton.
And she hadn't
eaten
for
2 days. She
hadn't
been
to
bed.
Been sleeping under hedges.
She's worn out.
Worn out and starving.
Sick from exposure.
Sick from exposure.
Half
crazy.
With the college right in front of her.
With the college right in front of her.
Rich men's sons.
Warm room, snappy clothes, good food.
Finally, she can't stand it any longer.
She
faints
in the snow. But first, she does a dance in the snow, half naked, to keep warm. Great scene.
No, no, Joe. It did snow in Princeton day before yesterday. Freak weather.
A student finds her.
A student finds her.
Beautiful
girl
on the frozen ground.
He rushes out.
He
finds she's still alive.
He takes her into his
room
and
rubs
her
arms and legs.
He undresses her.
No, 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 Joe. She's a good kid. Positively a good kid. I should know.
Oh. Oh. Mother. Mother.
My dear, what is it?
It's Paul. He's involved with a nightclub girl. A murderess.
Paul Lawton.
There's her picture in the paper. I'm going to break our engagement.
Oh, my dear, don't do anything hasty.
Read this. He asked us to take an interest in her.
What kind of an interest?
Oh, that's just a blind, in case we hear about her. Well, we'll take an interest in her. We're going down to Princeton this minute.
But, Francis, I don't understand, dear.
Take a telegram. The dean, Princeton University, Princeton, New Jersey. My nephew... Paul Lawton, senior class, wires me. He had met, quote, deserving chorus girl, unquote. Stop. Most unfortunate to expose him to dangerous associates. Suggest you investigate and advise me of situation. Charles M. Lawton, that's all. Find airplane schedule between Detroit and Princeton, that's all. Take a telegram. Paul Lawton, 54 Anderson Hall, Princeton, New Jersey. Astounded and uneasy contents your wire. Stop. Insist you drop affair immediately. Stop. Wiring Dean for explanation. You're being exposed to such influences at college. Stop. There is no such thing as a deserving chorus girl.
Good morning. Is Dean Mercer at home?
I'm expecting him any minute. Will you come in and wait?
Thank you.
Martha. Good morning.
Please don't stop playing. I just came to see the dean.
He'll be back soon. Make yourself comfortable. I was running over some of the music of the last Triangle show. It's very good. You know it, I suppose.
Yes, I'm Paul Lawton, senior class.
Oh, are you the Mr. Lawton that wrote this music?
Yes.
Enchanted, Mr. Lawton.
The enchantment is all mine.
Come over here.
I don't want to seem curious or anything, but I'd like to know who you are.
I'm Dean Mercer's daughter, Midge Mercer.
His daughter?
Yes.
Well, it's just that I didn't know the dean had a daughter.
I've only been home from Paris a little while.
Paris?
My mother was French. I've been living over there studying. Some of these songs are grand. Come on, start on this one. Wait a minute, Mr. Lawton. Don't spare the voice.
All right. Remember, you brought this on yourself.
I could sing your praises with eloquent phrases, describe you and bribe you with wonderful speeches. I could sing your praises with grand repartee, but darling, I desire to confess my love, express my love this way. I know the words that I use are simple and not very smart, but what I say to you straight from the shoulder, right from the heart. Others may sing of the spring, to them making love is an art, but when I sing to you straight from the shoulder, right from the heart. Who cares if others may laugh, if as a lover I am green? Who cares? Let them all laugh, long as you know just what I mean. It's old as the hills, it's true, to whisper I love you, I do. But when I say I love you, I do. And when I pray that we'll never part, it's straight from the shoulder, right from the heart.
Straight from the shoulder?
Right from the heart. Straight from the shoulder?
Right from the heart.
Say, who cares if others may laugh, if as a lover I am green? Who cares? Let them all laugh, long as you know just what I mean. It's old as the hills, it's true, to whisper I love you, I do. But when I say I love you, I do. And when I pray that we'll never part, it's straight from the shoulder, right from the heart to you.
That's lovely. Oh, you're not through yet.
Say, I'm here on serious business.
What have you been doing?
Doing?
When a student calls on father, he's generally been up to mischief.
Well, you're more or less right.
What have you done?
Oh, it's...
Come on, confession's good for the soul.
It's all rather foolish and complicated. You wouldn't care for it.
If you have a story to tell Father, don't you think you might better rehearse it on me? Come, come, Lawton. What have you to say for yourself?
Well, I think your father got a telegram about me.
Oh, one just came. There it is. Can you divine what it says?
Oh, something about explaining how it happens that a respectable Presbyterian university allows me to get myself involved with chorus girls.
I'm fascinated. Then you're involved with chorus girls?
No. That's why it's all so silly. I'm not.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
How do you mean?
Well, wouldn't you like to be?
No. Now that I met you, I got trouble enough.
Well spoken, sir. But if there isn't any chorus girl, why
but
should...
But there is.
Make up your mind.
Her name is Curly Flagg.
Well?
Well, Buzz Jones, he's the best friend I got in college. We met this girl, and she was hungry and had no place to sleep.
Yes?
She said she'd been a chorus girl in a nightclub in Philadelphia, and there'd been some trouble. So she ran away, and, well, we took her name and address.
Her address?
Yes, so we could let her know what turned up.
She didn't have any place to sleep, but she had an address. Care of Chase National, I suppose.
Oh, well, she knew where she could get a room.
Oh, it's a fine story. But I wouldn't try it on Father. Will you answer one question truthfully? Is she the girl the police are looking for in connection with that nightclub shooting business in Philadelphia?
What?
Yes or no?
Well, where did you get such an idea?
You used her right name, Curly Flagg, and it's been in the papers.
Oh.
It's all right, really. I'll never tell a soul. Now, if you'll tell me the truth, we'll see what can be done to help you. Where is she now?
In Buzz Jones's room.
What?
We cut her hair.
You did what?
We cut her hair with the nail scissors and we filed her away.
Oh.
Shh. We dressed her up like a boy.
Oh, I must see her.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. Now, see here, Mr. Lawton. I'll get you out of your trouble, but under certain conditions. I must meet Curly Flagg.
Oh, no. Can't be done.
If you'll promise to let me see that haircut, I'll open this telegram. If it's the one you're expecting, I'll tear it up. Father will never see it.
You'll do that?
If I can meet Curly Flagg. When is everyone likely to be out of the dormitories?
Well, nearly everyone goes to dinner within a few minutes after six.
Say, 6:10, then?
Well?
I'll be there at 6:10. What's the address?
54 Anderson. Oh, my uncle will expect an answer to this.
He'll get one. I can sign Mercer, Princeton University, without forging.
Oh, boy. For a while this morning, I thought I was going to get into trouble. Listen, you are my uncle. If there's nothing in this chorus girl business, then I'm a wonderful young man and the pride of the university.
You'd better let me write it.
Can it be the trees that fill the breeze with rare and magic perfume?
What's that?
Well, that's a song I've just written called Love in Bloom.
Sing it.
Sing it?
Mm-hmm.
Lady, for you, it's a pleasure.
Blue night and you, alone with me, my heart has never known such ecstasy. Am I on earth? Am I in heaven? Can it be the tree that fill the breeze with rare and magic perfume? Oh, no, it isn't the tree. It's love in bloom. Can it be the spring that seems to bring the stars right into this room? Oh, no, it isn't the spring. It's love in bloom. My heart was a desert. You planted a seed. And this is the flower. This hour of sweet fulfillment. Is it all a dream? Came to us in the gloom. Oh, no, it isn't a dream.
How do you do, sir?
Mr. Lawton wrote this music, you know, the Triangle Show, so he came over to play it for me.
Oh, yes. Very creditable. Please go on. Oh, Midge, is there a telegram here for me?
I'm sure there isn't.
Oh, I was told there was.
Oh, one came for me.
Western Union called me up and said they delivered one here.
Really?
Oh, but it's not important. They read it to me over the telephone. Oh, Lawton, will you drop in at the office late this afternoon?
Why, this afternoon, sir?
Are you cutting the faculty tea, Father?
Oh, yes. Well, make it early tomorrow, Lawton.
Yes, sir.
Come on, Mr. Lawton. Back to work.
What can I do about you know?
I'll surely think of something, hidey-ho.
No, do you mean just what you say?
Straight from the shoulder, right from the heart.
I need you more than words can express.
I'll help you later in the day. Yes, yes.
I'll appreciate everything you do. Straight from the shoulder, right from the blue.
This is it. You ain't gonna...
No, it's too early. We'll come back later. Quit shaking.
You're a fine cameraman, forgetting your light bulb. I didn't know it was gonna be this dark. I got some flash powder with me. Set up your camera. Arkle will be in on the 6:30 with a flock of light bulbs. You wait here. Okay.
Buzz Jones is out of town.
Well, cross my eyes.
All right, cross him.
Say, that's a good performance. I've seen women play little boys before, but, let me see you walk.
Let me see you walk. Just turn around and walk.
Now, listen, girlie.
I don't know what you're talking about or who you are, but if you don't get out of here, I'm gonna call my cousin.
Oh, forgive me, I'm sorry. My error. Read that and take it all back. I am the United States Cavalry, arriving just when the Indians have set fire to the ranch house.
How do I know you're Mr. McNeil of Super Sound?
A good question. And proof, my child, my driver's license. complete with signature and photographs suitable for framing. There is no McNeil but McNeil, and McNeil is his prophet.
Oh, gee!
Right. You are in the presence of one of the big men of your time. Now then, may we speak freely?
Well, I guess so, Mr. McNeil.
Very well, I'll speak and you listen. To begin with, how would you like to be featured in your very first talking picture?
Oh, wow!
Be quiet. If I feel an answer is required, I will wait for it. To continue, Mr. J. Thorwald Jones has an impression that Supersound might be able to use you. But he's not quite sure, and he's delegated me to decide. There are several things to be settled. Your age, your salary, your figure, such item. I think I can approve of your qualifications, although you may have to go to a hospital for a few days to have your voice cut out of your nose and grafted into your throat.
Well, listen.
You listen. I'll talk. If Supersound gives you a contract, I forgot to say that they will post the necessary bonds with the police for your appearance. Your legal troubles will be finished. Do you like that?
Well, I certainly...
All right. We're going to take a few photographs around here tonight, and tomorrow we will take the newsreel. But you are not to interfere with what I'm doing. I know my job, and you don't. For the duration of this here now emergency, you will cede yourself to me without question. In a nice way, of course. Your character, if any, in private life, does not concern me.
But look it, if you want...
You look it. Stop it and listen. Do as I tell you, and we may put you in a picture. In Yvonne L'Amour's play.
I'm taking Yvonne L'Amour's.
And if you're not better than she is, I will personally give you a kick in the trousers. Boys or girls, whichever you happen to be wearing, it makes no difference.
But Yvonne L'Amour, she always makes me cry.
All right, go ahead and cry. If it'll make you feel any better.
Oh, Mr. McNeil.
There. You'll have plenty of time to cry after you see your first picture.
Can I play the part? What's it like?
Well, you're dancing in a nightclub. A gangster comes after you. Somebody like, George Raft.
Swell.
He tries to make love to you, but you fight him off.
Comedy, huh?
Oh, no. This is serious. You are a pure, sweet girl.
Yeah?
But some instinct tells you what he wants, so you fight him off. He tears part of your clothes off, and you stand there before him, half-clothed.
Swell.
Now then, your brother comes in just in time and shoots him. You run away so you won't have to appear as a witness against your brother, and a college boy finds you and hides you.
Say, that's a coincidence.
Yeah, isn't it? Well, you and the boy fall in love with each other. But his father, a fanatic, accuses you of being a bad girl. You convince the father that you are pure, so he tries to get you. He tears your clothes off.
Gee!
This time the son rescues you and marries you.
Then he tears my clothes off.
That is an idea.
Where were you? In your tub?
Huh?
Keeping me waiting like that.
Oh, well, I was sort of expecting you.
Where's our heroine?
Oh, she's upstairs, but she'll keep.
What for?
Well, I don't know. It seems sort of comfy here. I thought maybe we might talk a little.
All right, let's talk.
Yes, well, I'm not so good at talking.
Oh, is this where the maestro writes his operas?
The maestro's been there all afternoon. Cutting two lectures in a lab session just to write something very special for this occasion.
Is this it?
Mm-hmm.
For me?
For you.
Well, I must hear it. I never knew anybody that wrote songs before. I knew a poet once.
Oh, I hate poets.
Well, this is a kind of poem.
Oh, no, that's a song. You see, I wrote that just to sort of show you how I feel. You know that all through the day I'm nervous and I'm restless, I'm fidgety, waiting for the day to hurry by. I kinda like the evening, give me that crimson sky when the sun is low. I'm riding high. I'm humming, 'cause my daily work is through, and I know the night is coming, and the night will find me arm in arm with you. I'm whistling looking at that lovely moon. When the stars above are glistening, I'm as tickled as a baby with a toy balloon. La, 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 I'm singing, happy as a boy can be. 'Cause I see you right there waiting, and you're underneath that usual tree for two. If you wonder why I'm humming, and if you wonder why I'm whistling, if you wonder why I'm singing, well, I'm singing and I'm humming and I'm whistling all the day, 'cause I'm on my way to you. Who you?
That's a lot better than talking. Are you going to devote your life to music?
Oh, no. Surgery and you?
Well, surgeons come in handy at times. May I keep this?
Well, you're the one it was written for.
I suppose the girls who come to boys' rooms expect a certain amount of messing about. I suppose you were no more than polite.
Oh, no, please.
Oh, I'm always getting into idiotic situations. I quite understand how you got the impression that this would be my idea of a perfect way to pass the time.
No, please, I didn't think anything of the kind. I didn't mean to kiss you.
Then why did you?
Well, because I'm in love with you.
Well, I'm not in love with you. Wait a minute. Or am I?
La, 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 I'm singing, happy as a boy can be, 'cause I see you right there waiting. Da, 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 da. I'm humming, and if you wonder why I'm whistling, and if you wonder why I'm singing, well, I'm singing and I'm humming and I'm whistling all the day, 'cause I'm on my way.
Now, see here, we'd better go up and see Curly Flagg. Do you realize the scandal there'd be if I were found here?
I don't think anybody would.
Mm-hmm. I thought I'd find her here. Very deserving. Oh, yes. So are you. I only hope you get what you deserve. As for you, you street person.
Francis, you're...
Shut up. I'm going to tell
my dear.
Oh, that's all very well, Mother. But if you think for one minute I'm going to walk into my fiancé's room and find him with this woman and not do anything about it, you just don't know me.
I'm afraid this is all a little over my head. I suppose it means something, but I don't know what. Paul might have explained it if he hadn't had his cataleptic fit just then. But thank you very much for a most entertaining performance.
That was Miss Mercer, the dean's daughter.
What? Oh, the dean's daughter. Well, in the first place, I don't believe it. In the second place, what was she doing in your room, whoever she is? She certainly isn't the type I'd trust alone with a young man.
Now, you shut up. I'd like to know who asked you to come into my room, sneaking in and trying to catch me at something, calling a nice girl who's the nicest girl you ever met, calling her filthy names.
Children, now, really?
Mother, we're going to have this out.
You bet we are.
Now, I won't have it, Francis. I can't allow it.
Where is your dear, sweet, deserving young chorus girl, then? Or are you afraid I'd offend her, too?
Well, you offend me. I'll tell you that.
Oh, no, Paul, dear. I've no doubt Francis is quite mistaken by the situation.
Mother, I won't have you saying anything.
Now, be quiet. So very many young men have got themselves into terrible, terrible trouble through befriending designing chorus girls.
Judging by the low taste you've displayed 100 times before.
No lower than the taste I displayed
please,
when I...
Please, Paul.
If you want to say anything about our engagement...
Quiet, Francis. Paul, I think it would be a good idea if you and I had a quiet talk together. Can't we go for a little walk outside?
Well, why not? I'm not enjoying this.
Francis can stay here and rest. I'm sure the strain has been too much for her.
Yeah? Who is it?
Boss Jones is out of town. And anyway, girls ain't allowed up here.
Don't worry about me, Miss Flagg. I know all about you, but I'm a friend. That is, I'm a friend of Paul Lawton's.
Oh, you're a friend of his, are you? Well, you can have him. And the next time you see him, you tell him for me I'll scratch his eyes out if I ever get a chance. I'm not used to men treating me the way he thought he could, just because he helped me a little.
What did he do?
What did he do?
Plenty, that's what he did, plenty.
I don't believe you.
Oh, don't you? You weren't there, were you? I fought him off tooth and nail. He tore the clothes off of me.
What?
Yeah. And as I stood there defending myself, some instinct told me what he wanted.
You're absurd. You're acting.
Oh, you think you know, do you?
I know that boy isn't going to get into any trouble on account of you. Goodbye, Miss Flagg.
If you see Lawton, tell him he reminds me of a horse, too.
I'll be delighted.
Do I look all right?
Shh. Yeah, stay there. I'm just getting my flashlight powder.
May I ask the exact meaning of this intrusion?
Oh, keeping the old hips in practice, huh?
I beg your pardon.
Easy, baby, easy. Play square with me, you'll get all the breaks.
I'll consider it a great favor if you leave this room at once.
I don't suppose you know who I am.
I feel quite sure that you're nothing that would interest me in the least.
Well, grab a load of this, baby. I come all the way from Philadelphia just to see you.
Will you leave, or shall I call a policeman?
Say, that's a gag. Call a policeman. Hey, listen, Quilly. I got no time to waste on wisecracks. You and me, we're going for a ride.
Please.
Huh?
You are quite the most loathsome person I've ever met in all my life. You make me quite ill. I shall have to ask you for the last time.
That'll make you ill, all right. And one more yip out of you, you'll get something worse, see? Give me that kind of lip, won't get you nowhere. I told you, you and me is going for a ride. And we're starting right now, see? What do you think I come to Princeton for? To go to college?
For you.
Buzz Jones is out of town.
Oh, yeah? Well, when will he be back?
I don't know. Oh, tomorrow, maybe.
Well, I'll just wait a few minutes and a chance. You see, I've been running, fella, and I want to catch my breath.
Well, catch it downstairs, can't you?
Oh, I'll only be a minute. Just long enough to have a smoke. Have one, kid?
No, thanks.
Say, what are they doing? Fighting a war around here or something?
Not that I know of. Excuse me, will you? I'm busy.
Oh, we'd never be happy together. It's all a mistake. The only thing is to just call it off.
Now, you mustn't say such things, Paul. You children are very much in love with each other, and... Oh, where is she? Frances.
For the love of Mike!
But, Frances, what on earth are you playing?
Here, here, put her on the couch.
Why, what is it? Frances, what happened? What happened?
He tried to have me kidnapped.
What?
Oh, don't be crazy.
He hit me.
Who did?
Your hired thug.
What?
He hit me right here.
Oh, she's just pulling some stunt to get a little sympathy.
Mother, get my things and take me home. Paul tried to have me murdered.
Oh.
Indeed, we'll go home. You don't have to have me kidnapped to get out of our engagement.
I wouldn't marry you if you were twice as rich.
Francis.
Hey, I guess I've been running along now.
So long.
So long.
Whoops.
Don't you just love Princeton?
Well, I don't go to school here. I just came down to visit my cousin.
Oh, just here on a visit, huh?
Yep, going back home tomorrow.
Back to the hilarity? Hello, Coily.
What do you mean?
Why, the boys at the hilarity asked me to look you up. They all says, give their regards to Coily Flagg.
I'm not Curly Flagg. I'm not Curly Flagg.
So you're not Curly Flagg?
No. No, no!
You know why I come down here, Coily? The Bulls is looking for a witness. If they was to find you, you might tell them what you seen the other night.
I didn't see anything.
Supposing the Bulls make you tell them what you seen.
But really, really, I didn't see anything.
Well, I ain't taking any chances. We're going for a ride.
What the?
A gunman from Philadelphia. Get his guns.
Here's another one.
Well, of all places.
Have you got some rope or something around here?
How about a towel or some neckties?
Fine.
Norton.
I'm sorry for the things I said to your girlfriend about you.
What do you mean?
Well...
Somebody's come.
Stop him!
What the...
Oh! What did you hit him for?
Well, I don't know him. Who is he?
He's the best friend I've got. You're pretty darn fresh, you are.
Well, with all these gangsters around here, I'm not taking any chances.
He was gonna get me in pictures. Now you probably ruined the whole thing.
Now you listen to me, Curly Flagg.
You didn't have any right to hit him. Why did... Stop hitting people!
Look what you've made me do.
Now I probably haven't got any job at all.
Oh.
Wait a minute. Turn your head to the right. Now, back where you had it. I don't know, turn it to the right again.
What do you think, Andy?
Well?
The first way was better.
You think so?
I liked it much better.
First way, Curly.
Hey, what with them boxing gloves would be nice?
A bright boy, bring him over.
Lead with your left, Coily. Lead with your left.
Go ahead, Curly.
Well, when I came to, they gave me some gin.
Ginger ale, ginger ale, and cookies. That's all they had.
Then I told them my story. They cut off my hair and dressed me up in boys' clothes.
They dress you?
Certainly not. Give the kid a break, can't you? She's a sweet, modest girl. She repulsed their advances.
Oh, they made advances, eh?
Well, college boys can't help making passes. You expect it of them.
They soon saw that she was not that kind of a girl.
Why, I said to them, I said, I may be in trouble like a sick horse, but that doesn't mean I want a schmoozling party.
You said what?
Let it go, let it go.
How many picks have we got, Andy?
50 or 60?
Well, we can use a lot more. Let's keep going. How are the boat holding out?
Okay.
Say, I look awful cute in the boys' shorts. Want a picture of those?
Sure.
in the private office, honey.
Okay.
What's going on here? What is this outrage?
They got us, pal. We've been waiting for you to come too, Grandpa.
Who are you and what's your name?
I'm the dean of this college.
All right, but what's your name? I'm from the United Press.
I don't care where you're from. You'll release me immediately and leave these premises.
Now listen, Dean. I want your name and I want a statement. Did you know the students were hiding a girl in this dormitory, hiding her from the police?
Oh.
Get that, Andy. You're putting them on, see?
Yeah.
Lift that leg.
I warn you. Release me immediately, or I'll have you placed under arrest.
Ah, don't be like that, or nobody will like you. Say, has anybody seen my dancing costume?
What do you think, Gus?
We don't know. He's a dean. We've only got his word for it.
That's right. He won't even give me his name.
Just an imposter, probably. Let him cool off. We got lots to do. We'll keep till later.
I warn you.
You said that before. Relax, Deanie, relax.
Hello? They're taking pictures upstairs. Newspaper reporters and everything. You ought to go up. Have you seen my dancing pants? Look, it. You've been wiping up the floor with them, and I've got to put them on. Say, don't come in here for a minute. Oh, come on upstairs. I'll get them to pose you with me.
Listen. Thanks to you, I've just written a letter resigning from college. And thanks to you, I just socked a man on the jaw who's the father of the only girl I... The only girl I...
There's your underwear. Look it, they're gonna star me in pictures. Won't you be proud of me?
For the love of...
Oh, well, you'll be sorry when you see my picture in the papers.
Hold it, Dean.
Well, Gus, how do you like me, huh?
Very sweet, girlie, very sweet. Get busy, Andy.
Stop this abomination. Stop it. You leave this building and the university grounds at once.
Now listen, Mr. Dean, we don't want to argue with you, but we're not quite finished yet.
Will you leave, sir, or will you not?
In a word, no.
Very well, very well. We'll see. I'll send for the police.
No.
That's fine. Just dial the operator and say, I want the policeman.
Now I'll see whether you leave or not.
Girlie.
Oh, please.
Stop that. You realize we found a gunman in this room with this gun on him?
Stop that!
Don't point that gun at people.
Huh? You'll all be put under arrest.
Give him the teeth!
Oh, you wouldn't have me arrested, would you?
Wouldn't I?
Andy! Did you get the arm around the waist?
Hey, jailer, I gotta get to a telephone.
Hey, officer, look. A brand new $20.
You have any right to keep your telephone. If you don't want the lawyers on this, you better look it up.
Telephone the Super Sound Theater in New York and tell them Gus is in jail again.
Go to the room and tell you who I am. I won't talk to nobody on the telephone.
Please, nice time, Mr. Officer.
Goodbye, Midge.
What?
I said goodbye. That's the tough part, so I want to get it over first.
Goodbye, and good luck.
Well, don't hang up.
The goodbyes are over.
Well, couldn't we talk our way backwards to the...
There's nothing to talk about.
You think I was trying to play two girls at once.
I counted three one day. That is, if I was included in your calculations.
Well, if I told you I never looked at any other girl except you, would you believe me?
No.
I didn't think you would, but it's true. I'm leaving Princeton today for good.
Hello?
What?
You started by saying goodbye. Well, I suppose hello is the end.
Well, don't hang up. Please don't. Are you crying?
No, I'm not.
Midge? Are you playing Love in Bloom?
I think so.
I just thought it would be nice to remember you singing our song.
Did you?
Won't you?
No. Can it be the trees that fill the breeze with rare and magic perfume? And it will be the spring that seems to bring the stars right into this room.
Oh, no, it isn't the spring. It's love in bloom.
My heart was a desert,
but you planted a seed.
And this is the flower, this hour.
Abominable.
Oh, my.
Drink your coffee, Father. Didn't you tell them who you were as soon as you became conscious?
No, not immediately.
Why not?
Well, I couldn't believe I was conscious. When finally I did break loose, they kept snapping their cameras at me. That picture is faked.
You don't need to tell me that, Father. Father, must both of those boys be dropped?
Are you preparing to defend them? Your friend, Mr. Lawton, for instance?
I have no defense for Mr. Lawton. Not now. Not any longer.
Mr. Lawton.
Well, Lawton?
Did you get my letter of resignation, sir?
It was most welcome.
I started to run away, but I read in the paper that you dropped Buzz Jones, so I came back to explain to you, sir, that the fault was entirely mine.
He knew of the girl's presence in the dormitory?
Yes, sir, but only after I told him. I don't mind my career being wrecked so much. I guess I had it coming to me for being such a sap. Sap wouldn't make a very good surgeon, would he, sir? But Buzz, Mr. Mercer, he must graduate. It means a lot to graduate from Princeton. That's all my fault about this girl. I absolve him absolutely. Can't you see, sir, another thing. I'm no longer engaged.
Engaged in what?
Engaged to be married.
Well, the newspapers might relish that information with photographs, but I fail to see its connection with the matter in hand.
Well, I just wanted everybody to know. It wasn't much of an engagement anyway. I mean, it wasn't very important, at least not to me. Just one more thing, sir. I want to apologize very deeply for hitting you.
For hitting me?
As you came through the door.
Oh.
Well, I didn't know it was you.
So you didn't know it was I?
Oh, no, sir. If I had, you don't think for a minute I'd hit her father.
Whose father?
Well, I'm sorry for everything, that's all.
Well, Dr. Walker, this is J. Thorvald Jones. I'm speaking to you in your capacity as trustee of Princeton University. I want to apologize for bothering you. But it seems to me that if Princeton University drops those boys, it will be a rebuke to the chivalry of the youth of America.
Senator, I've always so greatly admired your fearless championship of justice
that I want to call your attention to what is happening at Princeton University.
Circulate a petition. Start with the university clubs. Every college graduate in the country should be reached.
A graduate of Princeton University. My university was that of hard knocks. But if the newspapers of this great country have reported correctly the recent events at Princeton, I feel very strongly that a grave injustice is being visited upon the students involved.
Dreadful experience for a girl like me. I was dancing at the Hilarity Club in Philadelphia. I love dancing so much that where I dance doesn't matter. I am above my surroundings. The Princeton boys who took me in and sheltered me were just wonderful to me. Just wonderful. I'll never forget them, never. They'll always be just my boys.
We students who were dropped by Princeton University have no complaint to make against the college authorities. And if the faculty still feels that we no longer deserve to be graduated from Princeton, then all I can say is that whether on the football field or in life, Princeton men can take it.
Demonstration for Lawton and Jones.
There's a faculty meeting in the dean's office right now, deciding whether to reinstate them.
About finishes it. Got the books packed. You nearly ready?
Yeah. We can make the 9-10, huh?
Yeah. Well, goodbye, Princeton.
Tough luck, Wise.
So long, Skates. So long, Nolan.
There's life, there's hope, Wise.
Oh, cheer up. Mm-hmm. 10 years from now, we'll laugh at being busted out and everything. Paul, did you ever think if we hadn't come to Princeton, you and I couldn't have, well, gotten acquainted? Hi-ho.
Going back, 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 going back
flag and that press agent of your father's.
Oh, haven't they caused enough trouble around here?
Hello, Buzz. Hi, Mr. Lawton. Well, I'm glad to find you two together. Miss Flagg has come all the way down from New York just to thank you, boys. Come in, Miss Flagg.
My boys!
Oh, skip it.
Oh, boys, don't feel badly about being canned out of college. We're working on that, aren't we, Gus?
Sure, let's be friends. Let's all be friends. Now, I got a camera set up outside, and I want to get a picture of you two boys and Miss Flagg together.
Forget it, McNeil. It can't be done. We're already suspended, and one more flashlight with her, and we'll be hanged.
I think you and Miss Flagg had better go back to New York.
Not before we get a picture.
Well, you're not going to get one. Now, what do you know about that?
Any bets?
I'll bet you a poke in the nose if you try.
Yeah, you and who else?
Nix, Curly, Nix.
Oh, Mr. McNeil, these boys are just too young to appreciate what it means.
Come on, Buzz.
Hey!
Won't you be reasonable? Ah, hello, Mr. Dean.
Hello. We've been looking for you all over.
This is most unfortunate.
Mr. Dean, Miss Flagg has come all the way down to Princeton just to apologize to you.
Indeed. What's that camera out there for?
That is to take a picture.
If any more pictures are taken on the university grounds, it'll have a very disastrous result.
Well, if you don't let me apologize in front of the camera, I simply won't apologize.
Don't worry, baby. Before we leave, we'll have a picture of you and Professor Einstein thinking.
Lawton? Jones?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The deliberate propaganda and official pressure brought to bear on the faculty in favor of you boys have had nothing whatever to do with their decision to reinstate you.
No!
Yeah! And, Lawton, there's someone waiting outside to see you in her car.
Thank you. Thank you.
Huh? Give him a moment.
You can't hurt yourself. You can't possibly hurt yourself.
No.
You'll land right on their head. Remember, you want to jump towards the camera.
Yeah.
Now.
All right, sir. He's up. He's all right.
All it can be, as I see you right there waiting underneath the usual tree for two. And if you wonder why I'm humming, and if you wonder why I'm whistling, if you wonder why I'm singing, well, I'm humming and I'm singing and I'm whistling all the day, 'cause I'm on my way to you.